The first thing we need to do is to go to our browser and type in ER.GO. We go to the home page and to Servizi Online. We look for that keyword, Servizi Online, and we wait. Shouldn't take long. Okay, so here we go for students, of course. And then there are two ways to access. One is with speed, which is an electronic way of assessing your identity. You will know about this once you get here. You can only get it in Italy. So with this, you access usually with a QR code. And with this one, you simply go and access with university credentials. I can show you this. So here it is. You simply put your email and your password that you used for applying to the university. And this is in the case of the University of Bologna, but of course this applies to all of the universities here. I am going to access with speed because I already have it. So I just access with it. Okay, so here we are. We have to fill in the information for both personal data and economic data. First off, we go to the personal data item. And in this window, you basically just need to fill in all of your data. You select your country, of course, and you put everything here according to your information. Now, let's move on to the next step. And here you have to put your residence. If you are a second year student, just put where you're currently living at. Home address, if it's the same as the residence, you just put the same. Okay, so finally we arrive at the competitions benefits list. This list is all the benefits that you can apply to. If you send in all the economic documentation, so everything about your family's assets, liabilities, and properties, so basically your net worth, and if it's within a certain threshold, they will allow you to have these benefits. And these are the ones that don't require such documents. So now, do you want to declare the economic status of your family? Of course. Do you enroll in a PhD? In my case, no, because I'm doing the master's. And finally, you will have like a table like this, and just go and hit confirmo. Okay. Go back to the main menu. And now fill in the economic data. Okay, so incomes and assets of your family, if they are in Italy, abroad, or like in both. I will select abroad because nobody from my family lives in Italy, only me. Now you need to fill all of this information. Okay, so in this section, you only have to hit yes if you've been working and you have an income higher than this. And you have to have worked for at least 2 years. If not, just hit no and move on. Keep answering these questions. And now in this part, we have to add all of the members of our family. So your dad, your mom, your siblings. And for example, I'm going to add one of my parents. How many fathers do I have? So I have one. And so I add it. And so here you see, I put my father. You need to add all of the members in your family unit, so your mother, your siblings if you have, and then hit forward. Okay, so more questions. So siblings present in the family unit. This is kind of a weird question since we already answered that part in the previous section, but whatever, just answer it. And may bear in mind that this one includes yourself, so three brothers and sisters would be two siblings and yourself, and so on. And if none of these fits, then just click no selection and also select one of these cases and then hit forward. In this section, you have to specify whether your family has real estate or incomes and assets. So if your family owns any kind of property, you have to add it. And you have to specify the square meters and where it's located and to who it belongs and so on. And if it and for incomes and assets, you have to specify the amount in euro. You'll see here where do you have these assets, who are they from, and what exactly are those assets. So usually they refer to bank accounts. This is like the most common asset everybody has. Other kinds of assets are, I don't know, like investments, that they refer to investments, so probably bonds, index funds, and things like that. But I think like the most common ones are just like the money you have in your bank account. So you fill in this and then you move forward. Okay, so when you finish filling in your details and just hitting on complete, you arrive at this final section. So after this, you have basically finalized your application, but you still have to send, you still have to apply for benefits and send in the documentation. So we're going to click here. We're going to fill it in, forward. Okay, so here you'll see all your data. Just click on forward. Okay, so here just fill in what they're asking for. The first is in case you're applying as a first year student, and the second, well, if you're in second, third, or fourth year of your first cycle degree or your master's. Okay, here we just answer these questions. Most likely they're going to be no and no if you're applying for the first time. This section is a bit tricky. So here they ask you year of the course you're going to enroll in this academic years or academic cycle. You should put the year one if it's your first year, two if it's your second, and so on. Your very first enrollment at the university, first cycle degree means bachelor's degree. So here you put the year you first enrolled for your bachelor's. You first enrolled, not the year you graduated, right? And here the very first enrollment year for any type of master's. So if you had been in another kind of master's from another university, you should put it there. But if it's the first time you're applying to master's, most likely the answer is going to be this one, right? And here too, because this is the year you're currently enrolled in this particular second cycle degree course. And type of enrollment, well, it depends on your situation. This is the most common answer. The other ones are just special cases. And then you just hit forward. Okay, so bonuses. Bonuses are something that help you to get the minimum requirement of credits so that you can apply for the scholarship. You don't have to worry about this if you're just like a first year student. This only applies to students from second, third year, because they require you to have at least 30 credits at the end of your first year. So if you have, like, let's say 28 grades, you put here yes, and the amount of bonus would be 2, so that you end up having 30. So this is just like a help, and I think it's not like you can put here 30. No, there is a maximum amount of bonuses. I think it's like 4 or something like that. You can check the documentation for this, but if you have more than 30, you should be fine. You can put no and move on. And here, if your university is not listed here, so if your university is not an Italian one, you just select this one, which refers to universities abroad, and then hit forward. Okay, so in here, in green, just tells you all of the benefits you are allowed to apply based on your economic situation. Okay, so in this section, they are going to ask you, how do you want your scholarship to be distributed? So this first option refers to this. So in here, if you have up to this ESE value, they will give you this money in your bank account, and the rest they will convert it for you. So you won't see this money, they will keep this money from your scholarship, but you will have free lodging. So in reality it's not free, but this is the amount you're paying, and you won't see this money. This is the amount of euro you can spend in food, and this is the amount that is going to be used for any sport activities. So yeah, this is one option if you want ER.GO to manage your money. I think this is the cheapest one. I don't think you will ever find an accommodation like cheaper than this. However, it seems that only students that were already assigned of accommodation the previous year are supposed to apply to this. Were not supposed to, but allowed to apply to this. That's why it says reserved to these people. But if you want to see the money on your bank account, they will give you this. So you are allowed to administrate, so to manage your how you want to spend the money. In that case, you hit no, and you hit yes here, and you can also convert part of the money into food vouchers. So if you hit yes here, you put here how much money you want from your scholarship to be converted to food vouchers. The good thing about this is that if you choose this option, ER.GO will give you an extra amount of money. So this is, I would recommend this if you don't like to cook your own food. So you just go to a Mensa. So Mensa is basically like a food court for students where they can eat their lunch. And yeah, this is, if you go to the university and you like commuting and you don't mind spending time actually moving from one place to another, I would recommend this. But if you prefer to cook your own food and you want to save some money, yeah, I would say that maybe select no. That would be the best option for you. But consider this, that they give you extra money if you convert these to food. Now, this is only for people who are not applying for the scholarship. So, for example, if I put here no, then I can put here yes. So this is only people, this is the people who only want to apply for food vouchers. And international mobility grant refers to people who want to do an internship abroad. They will give you more money than to regular students who don't apply for the benefit. So let's say that they give you, I don't know, 400 euro per month to be abroad, then ER.GO will add 100 euro. Now, this is if you want to apply for lodging. This only applies if you selected this a scholarship and full fee exemption. So the scholarship amount, which is here, depending on your situation, this is the maximum amount you can receive if you are from abroad and you have very low income. So if you selected a scholarship and full fee exemption, so not paying fees, tuition fees, then you can apply for based academic achievements, based lodging. Here, yes. So listen, if you apply for this, you cannot apply for this. You cannot apply for this, and you cannot apply for this because it is all included in one thing. But if you select no here, then you can select here, this one, the scholarship, the food conversion if you want, the vouchers, the food vouchers, and the lodgings. So it just depends on whether you want like this extra sport, if you want basically ERGO to manage it this way. You can here in the other option, you can apply for the scholarship, the lodgings, and the catering service, but you don't apply for this sport activity. And the kind of accommodation, if you got it like the previous year, or if it's a new request. And this is just for people with disabilities, and then just hit forward. Okay, so in this section you're most likely to hit no, because I think this is very unlikely if you're applying from abroad. Just hit no and forward. Okay, so in this section you're going to answer to the question. If you have a double degree, this means that if it's a degree you get from the University of Bologna and from another university, often universities have like agreements. So if you graduate from the University of Bologna and you do an internship at another university, for example, you might get the degree from both universities. In my case, I would put no, because I think most programs don't have this double degree, but some of them do. And this is if I am doing like an internship, like those Erasmus internships, then in that case you might hit yes. You here put the number of months spent and the country you chose, and then hit forward. Okay, so here you should put the expected graduation date. This is the first session, the second session, and so on. I think most people graduate around this session, but you can be one of the first. So yeah, June and July is also another session. Once you decide in which one you are likely to graduate, in which date, then just hit forward. Okay, so this section I think only applies for students applying to second or third year. So here they tell you that after you graduate there is like this internship program that you can apply to, and the company is going to pay you this amount of money per month, and this is the minimum requirement for the company to pay you, and ERGO will pay 250 euro in addition to this monthly salary. So yeah, if you want, you can apply. Bear in mind that if you want to apply to a PhD and you're graduating in October, this is likely not going to be the best idea. So if you want to do a PhD right after you graduate, I wouldn't suggest this. But if you want to start working after you graduate, this is a spectacular option, given that ERGO is giving you this extra amount of money, which is significant, I would say. So it all depends on what you plan to do after you graduate. Okay, so finally they give you this report and they say that you have to check on the dossier utente page all of the communications they are going to send. So all of the notifications that you should be aware of. In here you just put your bank account details. Okay, so back to the homepage after you finalize your application, you go here and let's just select anyone. Here it says that you have to finalize the application with a PIN code. You click here and it will either send it to your phone number or to your email, so you can click here and ask it to send it to your email. So once you have it, you just copy and paste it here and click on finalize. And that's it. Then you can go back to the main menu. Okay, so we're now back to the main menu. So if you want to go to Dossier Utente, which is where you are supposed to send the documents, so you're supposed to send the documents here. You see Dossier Utente, and here you go. Here is where you need to log in and upload your documents. You're going to be sent a token to your email. This is a number. So here is where you're supposed to send the documentation. Envía documentación. You just click on Avanti and start uploading the files. So that's it. That's all the procedure.